Hey friends, it's Reverend Ben. This is your weekly video. I'm going to light our chalice and then give you the chalice lighting. This week's is from Sherry Woodbury. Again, we reground ourselves here in our highest values. Love is the center and foundation of this faith. Love is the power that holds us together as a community. As we enter into worship, then let us open our hearts to the healing power of liberating love. Because love is not only something we receive, but something we practice in community. Let fall away all that might distract us from the wholehearted practice of love. Let us be accountable to one another for doing the work of living our shared values through the spiritual discipline of love. As we continue to listen and learn, to act and grow, may each unfold in wholeness, both deeply loving and truly loved. There's been a lot of opportunity this week to love and to be loved. There were a lot of concerns raised during the joys, sorrows, and concerns. And I just want to hold those folks who spoke that day, also the ones who didn't speak that day because they were already in the hospital or already in a different health facility. I see you. I want to send you my love. And I want to thank the newly reconstituted care team for reaching out and visiting those folks. If you want to join that care team and do some visiting yourself, please contact me. Big thanks to Danny, to James, to Todd, and everyone for that wonderful reflection while I was gone over the weekend doing the Our Whole Lives, our OWL training. I'm recording this on a Tuesday. I don't know if it's going to get out today because it's already the afternoon, but I voted. It is my first time voting as a Gulfport resident. And if it is, if there's still time and you live in Gulfport, I encourage you to go out and vote for city council. Your vote counts, your vote matters, and we believe in the electoral process in our denomination. Now, on Thursday morning, it's my favorite Thursday morning of the month because we have the Interfaith Tampa Bay March breakfast meeting. Some of you have come with me to that before. So y'all should meet me there. The breakfast is at the Hangar Restaurant and Flight Lounge. It's at the little Alfred Whitted Airport in St. Petersburg, has a restaurant in the hangar. So meet us there. The breakfast goes from 9 to 10:30. You can meet folks from other faith traditions. And the food's pretty good too. We all pay for our own food there, but it doesn't totally break your bank. I really enjoy it. If money is tight, let me know, and we'll make sure you can be there. I don't know if you've seen this gorgeous sign out in front of our church for religious education. This sign comes to you after a lot of work from our RE department, in particular Janae Johnson, and it comes to you with a lot of work from Lisa. So please join me in thanking Lisa. Lisa works so hard, and on this particular project, she worked very hard. So please thank her. And her aunt Liz Allen, paid for most of the material. So I've never met her aunt Liz. So maybe if you see Lisa, also thank her aunt Liz through her. This week we have, I'm going to take this opportunity to say how much work the Friday Night Sunset Supper volunteers do. There's two sets of volunteers. One does food and the other works in the little house. And they do so much work. But guess what? We are expanding what we offer to the city's unhoused and homeless folks through collaboration with other agencies. So please sign up to volunteer for the Friday Sunset Supper by contacting Sabina von Alok. Or if you want to volunteer in the little house to arrange clothing and toiletries, you can contact, I would say just contact the office and we'll put you in touch with those folks. Now, Saturday mornings, there has been a Food Not Bombs set up quite near the church, but I think they are moving to the church. So that's exciting. There's an opportunity to serve food to unhoused people on Saturday mornings. You can contact Gordia, Danny, or either Showalter, Paul or Carrie Showalter. All four of them are involved in the Food Not Bombs. This Saturday afternoon, there's going to be a group called Dinner and Duds that's giving away, you guessed it, food and clothing in our playground. Now, again, this is both Food Not Bombs and Dinner and Duds are groups that were happening anyway near our church, and we're starting to partner with them, thanks mostly to the relationship building by Cheyenne. And then finally, on Sunday, the community free store after worship will be in the backyard, and that's a collaboration between our own bodily autonomy team and PPA Pinellas. They provide material aid to our local unhoused community, and they call it mutual aid. It's really exciting. Gordia will also be leading worship this Sunday. I'm really excited for that, so I hope you can attend. I will be there this Sunday as opposed to last Sunday. I don't have an owl training, but it's called Transforming Into Your Authentic Self with Allison Longkey as the worship associate. So join us on Sunday, but there's plenty to do during the week before that. The month of April is going to be pretty busy. One more thing about this Saturday. It's the first of two offerings of the Living the Pledge workshop. The UU St. Pete Racial Justice Team has a Living the Pledge workshop this Saturday from 9 a.m. to 2 p.m. And then the second one will be Saturday, April 13th from 9 a.m. to 2 p.m. I'm really excited to attend this. I can't do it this time, but I am going to get it next time. I hope you all can do it this time. Please contact Christine Barker if you want to sign up for that. Next week, the citywide iftar dinner, sponsored by local Muslims and Muslim associations, is going to be at the Coliseum. That'll be on the 26th of March. I'm really excited to attend that, and I am going to attend that. The dinner is free, so get your tickets. It'll be, again, Tuesday, March 26th at 6 p.m. Now, I was mentioning April. Starts off with the Florida UU Women's Retreat. It's April 5th through 7th. It's right around the corner at Day Spring Conference Center. Contact Dana or April for that. And then on Sunday, April 7th, we'll have Prayer in the Park. That's at North Stroud Park, and that is sponsored by Interfaith Tampa Bay. They've asked yours truly to do a prayer in the Unitarian Universalist tradition. Then our UU St. Pete annual Seder will happen on April 24th at 5:30 p.m., UU St. Pete. My installation as your settled minister will occur on May 25th, and contact Sabina if you are willing to help with that. Now we're going to extinguish this flame, this physical flame. But when we do that, guess what we do? That's when we ignite it in ourselves. Then the flame in us becomes an unquenchable fire as we love one another and do this essential work of interdependence. I'll see you Sunday. Blessings.